Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this lesson, we will put some light on the FIDIC and the claims. FIDIC and the claims is important in your construction projects to understand what FIDIC say, what is FIDIC at all, and why it is used in the claims. So mainly the contractor claim entitlement has three channels to get through. You have the contract, you have the law, and you have the mutual agreement. For the contract, if it is very clear, you have the clauses, then you can get your entitlement very easy. If you have disagreement between you and your client or contractor, then you might go to the law, which is here the court, and starts arbitration. And you might have something in the middle, in between, which is mutual agreement. And usually, this is the most effective way to resolve the claims. So, we would like to tell you what is FIDIC. FIDIC is the International Federation of Consulting Engineers. It is a French name, and it is commonly used in construction projects. Why it is commonly used? Because it has a standard form of contracts. You might have civil engineering projects, which is usually globally, and they put the best practice of the project. But since the projects are not typical, they have some different books or different contracts according to the project type. All I need from you at this stage of the training to just understand the differences between these books. If we say the green book, it is a straightforward or quick and cheap project. So if you have a small project, no complication, go to the green book. If you have the project more complicated or traditional project, but it is under the employer design, then you go to the red book. If the contractor will design the project, then it is better to go to yellow book. If it is EPC trunk project, you might go to the silver. If the contractor is involved in the operation, then you definitely need to go to the gold book. If you understand this nice graph, you will find how easy it is. The construction project, is it simple? Yes, go to the green book, that's it. If it is not easy, then you can go to the second equation. Is it employer design? If yes, then you go to the red book. If it is not the employer design, then you go to ask yourself another question. Is there any high risks or unforeseen risks? If no, then you ask another question. Is it lump sum with little employer involvement? If it is yes, you go to silver. If it is no, you go to back to the green. But if you have a maintenance by the contractor, then you go to the gold. If no maintenance by contractor, you go to the yellow. So the FIDIC contract has certain procedures to apply when you have a claim. And here we would like to tell you, if you have a claim-based contract, sometimes the contract is not 100% based on FIDIC, but they got some clauses from the FIDIC and they start fine-tuning or adding or removing. But in the terms of claim, if you have a project based on FIDIC contract and you are going to do a claim, you need to understand the claim procedures in FIDIC. I will leave this presentation for you. You can download it. It has more explanation than I say here in the video. But I would like to tell you that FIDIC has some certain limitations. What I mean by this, that you have to give a notice within certain amount of time from the delay happening. For example, here in FIDIC, it is mentioned that 28 days, no later than 28 days, you can report event that causes for you delays. If the contractor fails to give a notice within 28 days, there is no extension of time. There is no claim at all. So this is very important to understand. Not only this, after you give the notice within 42 days, you should provide a detailed claim. If you fail to do this also, well, you will lose your rights in asking for extension of time. Okay, a claim that has been submitted is considered a progress claim. The contractor continue to submit other claims at monthly intervals. The contractor send his final claim within 28 days from the date of the end of the effect, because you might have something continuously. And here also, the FIDIC give timeline for the engineer. The engineer is the person or the organization who is responsible of reviewing your claim. It should reply within 42 days. Also, you'll find this chart is very useful if you understand. Here we have a claim. The first question will be asked, did the contractor submit a draft claim within 28 days? If no, then there is no entitlement at all. If yes, then the second question will raise, detailed claim was submitted within 42 days? Yes, okay, we'll go to the second question. Did the engineer respond within 42 days? If yes, then we'll go to the next question. If no, the contractor has the right to go to the dispute resolution board or DAB. So this graph also you can download it from the link below, will give you the whole procedures of claims under FIDIC. Okay, but now one of the good things about FIDIC contract that the engineer response should be limited to one of these three: approved, detailed comment if any determination, disapproved with detailed comment, or request for further information. Here we can find in some cases that the client or the consultant, which name here by engineer, could reject a claim without further explanation. This is not the case if the contract is under FIDIC. He should provide detailed comment why he is agreeing about the claim. Okay, so what if the engineer didn't approve the claim? You can go to the dispute board, because this will be defined in the claim and FIDIC contract that, okay, if the contractor and the client didn't agree about something, will we go directly to the court, or we can assign a third party? This third party could be one office or more than one office to check our case. Then he will give us his opinion. If we agree, then we can reach mutual agreement. If we don't agree, then we can go to the final step, which is the court. Also, amicable settlement. If we don't agree about that decision, then we might negotiate further and reach to an agreement. And also in the FIDIC, there is a limit or time limitation to resolve this in a mutual agreement. The final thing is to have arbitration, and arbitration will go to the court, and it will be according to your country that which court is relevant to see the claims and take a decision of it. Also in the arbitration, normally you'll find three arbitrators appointed according to the rules in your country. The arbitration will involve witnesses for engineers, which will involve detailed documents. That's why in the first place, when we prepare a claim, we will consider the worst case scenario that we are in front of the court and we should have every document in our case. There is one term in the contract in FIDIC I would like to tell you, because you might not be aware of it, which is termination, contract termination in FIDIC. In your opinion, when we can terminate a contract? Contract termination refers to its end before all the parties fulfill their obligations or completing their tasks. So in FIDIC, as a client, you can terminate the contract if the contractor don't give you the proper or failure within a specific period of time, but only after giving a notice to the contractor and request the contractor to correct the failure within a specific period of time. This is very sensitive, because it gives the right to the client to terminate the contract, and normally huge financial damages will be applied to the contractor. So after receiving the notice to correct the fault, the contractor has 14 days. Imagine this short period. So this also something you need to understand of the FIDIC claims. If you are under FIDIC claim, check this clause, because it is very dangerous. What I'm telling you, that the payment after termination under FIDIC, after the termination of the contract, the owner has the right to demand the contractor of that additional cost or extension of the works and all other costs reasonably incurred by the employer due to the contract failure. And this actually, if you reach this stage, huge damages, cost damages will be applied to you, because any losses or damages suffered by the employer in completing the work will be also the contractor fault. All delay damages case that the work was not completed within this specified time. This was only my thoughts about the FIDIC terms in our course. I give you only few things, but the presentation will have more information. If you are interested, you can download it and check the other contents in the presentation. Now we finish this stage of work. Let's go to the final stage in the project management, which is the closing. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next one.